Today, I'm on a mission to explore Denia, a town about 40 kilometres north of Benidorm. Ian kindly dropped me off at Finistrat station, which is 2 stops from Benidorm. The whole trip took a couple of hours and required a change at Tolada, but it's impossible to get lost as there's only one line going north and one going south. So you get off the first train and just wait for the connecting one on the same platform. The train journey was one of my favourite parts of the day. The tracks wind up through the mountains with a wonderful sea view. It was really relaxing just to sit and stare at the world going by. Guys, I've just reached Denia. I've decided to go on a wander for the day. It's taken me a couple of hours to get here because there were a couple of train changes along the way, but it was fairly easy to navigate because literally the line just goes along the coast and you get on at one end and get off at the other. So it's now about 2 o'clock and it's a little bit overcast, a little bit spitting, but that's my kind of weather because I'm British and I burn really easily. So I'm quite happy with overcast. So I'm gonna head towards the coast and see if I can get something to eat. And then I think there's a castle. So I'm gonna go and see if I can find the castle and have a look around. So yeah, welcome to Denia. The only question is which cafe to choose from, because there appears to be a lot of them. Instead of butter, it's more usual to put olive oil on your bread in Spain. Okay, so I've just had the strangest definition of tacos. And I'm off to find the castle, which should be that way. Like the church at Altea, this one also has a bell tower, possibly added when the town was converted from Islam to Christianity in the 1200s. So one thing about Europe is steps. Steps all over Europe. In every country, in every village. Castle seems to mostly be scaffolding and fencing. So far I have failed to locate the entrance. So yeah, I definitely feel like I've come the wrong way, so maybe I need to go back and up. So I can see people up there, but I'm not sure if they're builders or tourists. A guy came up to talk to me with his kid and he didn't speak any English. I don't speak any Spanish, but I kind of pointed left and right because the castle was in front of me and it's like, well, do I go down the hill to go in or up the hill? And he sort of pointed and went, no, castle down the hill. Now he was right, because you do get a very good view of the castle standing right next to it, but there's currently no way to get in down there. So I've just turned around and I'm walking back up the hill to try to find the entrance. Okay, this is starting to look more castly. That's pretty fantastic, with the mountains in the background and the clouds. Yep, according to the houses, we're going in the right direction. Finally made it in, and we are here, and just behind is a tower with an exhibition in, and then we go for a walk around here. There's a museum and some remains of the ruined castle and a coffee shop, so let's do it in that order. So this exhibit appears to be entirely in Spanish with no English, and unlike in France, I really can't pick up much from the writing. So I can read French, but I can't really make it come out of my mouth or understand when people talk. But with Spanish, I can't even read Spanish. Interesting, because all of the other museums I've been into have offered either a guidebook in English, English translation on the wall, or in some cases audio. But yeah, there's really nothing in this exhibit that I can understand. Nice pictures though, and a fabulous view. Look at that out the window. I'm guessing that these are all old artifacts that they've found around the castle over the years. Hi guys, so I'm at the top of the tower that I think I photographed earlier with the people looking over. I just find everywhere so far in Spain, my eyes are drawn to the mountains. It's flat, flat, flat. Then each city or each village seems to have this great big chunk of rock with clouds over the top of it. So in Finisterre, it's, I can't pronounce it very well, but is it Campania? but everywhere you go, there just seems to be a chunk of rock that draws your attention. So I guess in the villages in France and other European cities that we've been to so far, that's usually a basilisk, or it's a temple, it's something up on a hill that you're drawn to. But you know, the mountains here just eclipse everything else. It's really quite a sight. Yeah, I'm enjoying Spain. I'm a bit perturbed because, as I mentioned, because I've lived and worked in Rwanda for, you know, 15 years or so, I'm quite used to listening to French and to reading French and English translations side by side. So my ability to read French, if I go to a museum in French, I can usually pick it up, but in Spanish, I can't, and I'm slightly perturbed by that. But yeah, anyway, let's head back down and have a look around the castle. Everywhere you go in Spain, you see this dry wall terracing. And apparently, it's to help to conserve water because there isn't very much rain. So, by planting things on terraces, you can keep the rain a little bit and help to prevent the landslides, I guess. But a lot of it looks really, really old. This looks like some kind of graveyard. Time to break open Google Translate again. So there's been a few museums that we've been to so far that haven't really had displays in multiple languages or offered options for other languages. And I kind of have thinking it would be really cool if Google developed some glasses. I know they had Google glasses, that wasn't a great success. But for museums, if they just had glasses that you could just look at a display and it automatically does the translation. I guess either visually or to audio, maybe you could choose, because I guess that would save museums a lot in having to find space for all of the different language translations, having to guess at which languages are going to be visiting, because Google Translate now can do Chinese, all the European languages, even a little bit of Kinyarwanda, though it's still got a way to go with Kinyarwanda, but yeah, it would just be nice if there was the option to put on some glasses and just look at a display and get the audio or the text in your own language. Hello, castle cat. Hello, Lola. Hello, little castle cat. How are you? How are you, castle cat? Nice to meet you. Oh, hello. Hello. Do I smell good? Do I smell of food? Lovely castle cat. Okay, so I think I've discovered something interesting. I might be wrong and I need to ask Maya and Tyre about this, but I think that the first translation here is in Valenciana, whereas the second translation here, so it's a really, really noisy seagull. Have you quite finished? Are you done? Okay. Yeah, whereas I think the second one is actually in Spanish. And the reason that I think that is because when I do Spanish to English translation and hold it against the first one, it comes out really hard to understand, maybe not, but when I hold it to here, the translation seems to come up well, much faster. But it seems to be repeating the exact same information. See, we've got, it says like Segla 2015 here, Segla 15 here again, Siglo 16, Segla 16. So it's definitely two different languages. And as we're in the region of Valenciana, that's what I guess it is.
But it's interesting because Google Translate does appear to be distinguishing. It seems to now be translating both of them equally as well. So the lady at the booth assured me that there was a cafe up here somewhere. And this seems to be my life on this trip, is climbing steps in search of cafes. What do we reckon? I don't know, it doesn't look terribly reassuring. Okay, so now we're going down the steps. Okay, at the bottom of this, I think I need to stop and check the map. Okay, I'm really confused. So we started there, and then we came up and round here. Have I just come down here when I should have gone up there? I'm really confused. I get a really horrible sense I'm about to go back up these steps. But then again, if I have just come down there, then if that is that, then that leads up to the same place. So let's try that. Oh, we found Castle Cat again. Castle Cat, hello. Off to defend the castle. Hold on, somebody's driven up here. That's got to be cheating. It's got to be a gate into the fairy world. Stairs, always more stairs. These are posh steps though. These ones look like they're made out of marble. Oh, this must be where the people were that we saw from very bottom. That would make more sense. Let's go and see if we can see where I was standing a minute ago. Well, about 45 minutes ago. I'm not entirely sure about the translation of this, but it's the remains of an older castle, I think. Wow, those seagulls are really at it. Let's see what this says. Yeah, I think it's just talking about when different parts of the castle were built and the different architectural designs. Right, let's go and look over the edge. Pretty impressive view of the port. Oh, yeah. That is exactly where I was standing when I was down on the ground. I couldn't find the entrance. So we've gone all the way from down there, all the way up and around the town to the top of the castle. Right, I feel like maybe we should head down to the harbour and try to find something to eat and drink.
very impressive view, but definitely time to go because the rain is coming in.
Just on my way down the steps and I found this little alcove here. Let's go see what's inside it. Oh, photograph display. Old pictures. These are really interesting photos, but they don't have any dates on them. I'm guessing, I don't know, by the dress of the people in it, that's probably about the turn of the century, so early 1900s. The writing on this one makes me think it's maybe from an old postcard. That's from the bay. Huh. I think we've found the museum. But where's the cafe? So that isn't the seagulls. So the seagulls are there and they're not making any noise. And that appears to be a loudspeaker. And I think the loudspeaker is supposed to frighten away the seagulls. But that definitely isn't happening.
Okay, so that was interesting. I went up the steps to the museum and immediately was told no photographs. I just feel like that's museums nowadays shooting themselves in the foot. So I was really surprised when I went to, especially the Van Gogh Museum, the Musical History Museum. Like when I was a kid, you weren't allowed to take photographs at all. You weren't even allowed to take your camera out in a museum. So I was asked, to stop taking photographs in a museum in, oh, this is so irritating. Yeah, come on, have a look at this. This is clearly the worst idea ever. So I think that's supposed to scare off the seagulls, but it's just scaring off the tourists, I think. So it's playing birds screaming and gunfire. And the seagulls don't give a damn. All it's kind of serving to do is really irritate anybody walking past, especially if they're trying to vlog at the same time. Yeah, so as I was saying, I was asked to stop taking photographs in a museum in Dresden. So in Dresden, they have this really cool, like, I don't know how to explain it. It's like toys, like old early wooden carved toys and things, and there's a museum to those, and it's really, really cool. But I used to write a blog long before I started doing YouTube, and I wanted to take some photographs for the blog, I get confused nowadays. But you know, I was very swiftly told not to do that. Now growing up, I was used to that. You're not allowed to take photographs in museums. But now, like France, Belgium, everywhere that we've been down there, it's completely changed. Is people actually want you to take photographs. So the Van Gogh exhibition, oh, flipping hell, what? There's another one. I don't know if you can see it, but there's another loudspeaker there and it's just screaming at you. This is like the worst idea ever. I mean, buy a Kestrel or something. Let me wait until that's finished. So I finally found the cafe and I was going to sit down and have a cup of coffee, but with that screeching sound, I don't think that I can be bothered. I think let's go down to the port and get something somewhere where they're not blasting screaming seagulls and gunfire from a loudspeaker. So yeah, what I was trying to say is the Van Gogh Museum, they even had a part at the end saying, you know, create your own art, tag us in, you know, on Twitter, on Instagram, on social media. And I think that's the way to go, because people used to think that, you know, if you took photographs in a museum, that... We can't keep talking here. Let's go and talk somewhere else. Yeah, so people used to think that if you took photographs in a museum, that people wouldn't want to go and visit that museum because they would have already seen everything. that totally isn't the case. You know, you're never going to document everything in a museum. You're just going to talk about the things that you find interesting and give a sense of what that museum holds. So other people, if they're in the area and they've heard about this museum, they've seen sort of teaser trailers for it, they're going to go, and it's going to stick in their head more because they're going to have seen it. And yeah, so I think it's a better idea to let people take photographs in museums.
I think that guy was a fellow YouTuber. We just waved cameras at each other.
Yeah, so these are two seagulls who are completely nonplussed. I know. Completely nonplussed by that loudspeaker. I know. Irritates me as well, mate. Good luck. So let's start walking back down towards the harbour. I don't know if you guys have ever seen, there's a Korean series on Netflix called Memories of the Alhambra. And it begins, like the first episode is so clever because it just begins with this guy testing out augmented reality, where he's walking around the streets in Spain. And he's looking, he's got to find like a sword, and the sword is in this cafe's toilet. So there's these people sitting in the cafe, and he just walks through, gets the sword, goes out, manages to get killed, resets in the game and has to go and get the sword again. So you just see him walking in and out of this cafe continuously. And because nobody else has got the augmented reality vision, they can't see the sword, so they have no idea what he's doing. But walking around old castles like this, I can't help but thinking that augmented reality would be quite good fun, wouldn't it? You know, if there was some sort of game that you were playing, maybe combining that with the glasses with the translation in it, so that you could see things that you can't normally see and play a bit of a game, because it's just the atmosphere of these places. And don't get me wrong, I like old history, and I like my old history straight up, no sauce. So you know, I love to walk around old cathedrals, I love to walk around old churches, but you know, every now and again maybe there's a place like this that, I mean, it's interesting but it's not mind-blowingly interesting. And maybe this particular castle would be a good experimental place to try augmented reality, I don't know. Although, to be fair, there were enough children accidentally falling over the cobbles as it is, so maybe getting adults running around as well isn't a great idea, but I really like it here. Yeah, it's a nice bit of history. I think my favourite part is just, you know, the mountain. Every time I look up, there it is. And there's something about a mountain that's got its head in the clouds that's just a little bit awe inspiring, no matter where you are. So sorry, yeah, I mean, I don't mean to be rude when I say it's not mind-blowingly interesting. It is still really interesting, but I think, you know, you forget how many churches. Every village has a church. Almost every town has a castle in Europe, many places in the UK as well. And we're kind of a bit spoilt by them. So, you know, if you've never seen a castle before, if you're coming, I guess, from somewhere like, I don't know, like America, Australia, and you've never seen something like this before, then yeah, this is good enough.
Bye bye, Castle Cat. Bye bye, bye bye, bye.
But yeah, it's like there are some places that you go out of your way to go and see, like I think the Basilica at Lyon. You know, if I'd known about that and I was in the vicinity, I would have specifically gone to see that. Whereas this is nice, but I'm coming to visit it because I'm staying with friends about an hour away, and it was something to do for the day. So yeah, if you're in Denia, definitely.
This store's pretty impressive.
That was absolutely adorable. I was just coming down these steps and there was a very young couple here kissing, just like snogging, going for it. And they had like their camera out and they were filming themselves. And I'm like thinking, what's going on here? And I came past and I asked them, you know, is this a special wall? Because it's got lipstick marks all over it. And apparently it says, kiss me in this corner. So I think it's a local landmark where people come to take a picture of themselves kissing. It's quite cool. But it was kind of funny just to kind of look down the street and find these two people just snogging and filming themselves. It was like, what's going on?
I think this is a better idea than the love locks because it doesn't sort of weigh down the architecture and cause problems and need loads of people to remove them.
Okay, so I'm not entirely sure where I'm going. Just gonna walk around until I find a sign that says port this way. Okay, definitely raining at the moment. I'm doing my Madonna headscarf trick to keep it off. I think I'm almost at the water. I can see palm trees and I can see boat sails, so I think we're almost there. Oh, this is a cool piece of art. I like that. It's a fish filled with plastic and rubbish from the sea. It's a reminder of the damage that that's doing to the ocean. That's very nicely done. Okay, so I've got this one, I think is called Turu, and I think that looks like fudge. I'm not too sure, but it looked really good. I've got pistachio because I love pistachio ice cream. That's my dad's favorite, and we always used to have that on holidays. So pistachio ice cream makes me think of holidays. And then I went for this blue one, which is just called unicorn, and I'm very confused to find out what it is. Sorry, did I say confused? I meant excited. I'm really excited to find out what it is. Okay, let's give this a go. So this one is the Turo, which I think is fudge. I'm not sure, kind of fudgy caramelly. Well, it's good. No, it's really good. Pistachio. That is really good pistachio ice cream. That really does taste of pistachio. Very good. Now, I had to know what it was. Oh, it smells of bubble gum. Okay, so I can confirm unicorn ice cream is indeed Hubba Bubba. Definitely taste of Hubba Bubba. Ah, I got a little bit, it's got multicolours. Marshmallow. So that was a fun day in Denia. I went to see the castle, got something to eat, wandered around the back streets, and now I'm heading back to the station. It's about 5:30. So by the time I get back, Maya should be able to pick me up. So yeah. Sorry, I just got a bit distracted. There's something over here. It looks like ancient remains. Okay, I'm going to have to look this up when I get home because the translation is not entirely straightforward. But it seems to be some sort of necropolis. So a very, very ancient burial place. And I think it's saying that there's one in the south of the city and one in the north. And this is the northern necropolis. So the dead were buried just outside the walls, I think, for hygiene purposes. So they didn't pollute the water systems and so forth. And so that's what this is. It reminds me a little bit of Gloucester, when you're just walking down the street and then there's this sudden Roman northern gate on Northgate Street and one on Southgate Street, just buried into the pavement whilst you're walking past. So I guess that's what this is, a necropolis at the Northern Gate. And it says that they found 679 graves or burials here. Right, bar that little distraction, let's head off to the train station. Oh my goodness, look at that view behind the train station. Look at that massive mountain with all the clouds on it just sitting behind it. Well, that was amazing timing. This is the train has just pulled in. I had just enough time to arrive at the station, pop to the loo, and the train is now here. Going to Tallada and then changing there for Benidorm.
That was incredible. That woman ran for the train after it started moving, and the train stopped to let her on. You would never see that in England. Buses, maybe, but never trains. Another thing that's really weird as a Brit is the idea of physically crossing the train lines to change platforms. In the UK, it's always a bridge or an underpass. Maya collected me from the station and we headed home for a well-earned drink.
Yes.